here. I want to clarify something. In the course of this prank, this crank call that you got, it was suggested by someone who was a liberal blogger that you might think about planting troublemakers into the crowd. And you said, quote, "We thought about that." Is that right? You really thought about trying to bust up physically these protests? No, we thought, as the call continues, and I've said repeatedly, we rejected that. But we have people all the time who contact us for and against this bill, and you can imagine people with all sorts of ideas and suggestions, and we look at everything that's out there. But the bottom line is we rejected that because we have had a civil discourse. We had, you know, a week ago, 70,000 people. We had more than that yesterday, and yet we haven't had problems here. We haven't had disturbances. We've just had very passionate protesters for and against this bill, and that's okay. That's a very Midwestern thing, but we're not going to allow anybody to come in from outside of the state and try and disrupt this debate. They can inform it, but we're not going to allow them to disrupt this debate and take the focus off the real issue here. And the issue is the people in Wisconsin, particularly those 14 state senators, need to come home and have the debate here in the state capitol.
Governor Walker, we will leave it there. Thank you very much.
Thank you, David.
And we'll have much more on this debate coming up in our political roundtable, where we will be joined by AFL-CIO President Richard Trumka. But first, to discuss the other big story this week, the unrest in the Middle East and the violence in Libya by the regime of Muammar Gaddafi.